Hello, I'm Bruce Haber with the HUD Office of Lead Hazard Control and Healthy Homes. We're here today to conduct a clearance examination of this 1962 home. This home was renovated with private funding from the owner, and if it had been a HUD-funded rehabilitation, we would have required a clearance examination at the conclusion of the rehabilitation before it could be occupied. Our homeowner knows about lead-based paint, and they want to assure that it's lead safe before they reoccupy it. And so, while not required, they are conducting a clearance examination, and Bill and Terrell, our two risk assessors, are here to conduct the testing, so let's go meet them now. So we're here with Terrell and Bill, our risk assessors, who are going to conduct the clearance examination today. But before we get started, Terrell, I'd like to ask you, like, what is a clearance examination, and why do we conduct one?
A clearance examination is an on-site inspection to make sure that the repairs have been satisfactorily completed and also that the home is safe for reoccupancy.
So when does a clearance examination take place?
A clearance examination takes place following the repairs and cleanup, but no sooner than 1 hour after cleanup.
Are there any times clearance examination are required?
Absolutely. HUD requires clearance examination with paint disturbing activities above the de minimis levels. Some jurisdictions require clearances for rental properties, for instance, before a family moves in. In all cases, it's to make sure the home is safe for occupancy.
So who can conduct a clearance examination?
Clearance examination can be conducted by a risk assessor, a lead inspector, or a clearance technician, unless abatement was done. Then only the risk assessor or lead inspector can perform the clearance.
So what are the steps in sequence that we do in order to do the clearance examination?
Okay, the first thing we do is find out the reason for the clearance examination. So if there are any reports that were provided, risk assessments, we get those and we review those so that we can see what the scope of work is. Once we know what the scope of work, we know what we have to do when we go on site. So we check to make sure that the repairs that needed to be done were satisfactorily completed. We check to make sure everything is clean. We collect dust samples. We have those analyzed and we generate a report and share that at the end.
And so Bill, before we get started, what are the tools that you're using for the clearance examination?
The tools are basically the same as the tools we use for risk assessment. We have gloves, we have tubes, we have lead wipes, and we have tape and the tape measure.
Okay, so now that we've had a little background on when it occurs and how it's going to take place, let's go ahead and get on to our clearance examination. So we finished our visual assessment, we finished the dust testing, and Bill, when you were dust testing, I noticed you also tested this hallway. Can you explain to me why?
Well, the hallway is a room equivalent, and the contractors could have tracked lead through the hallway going from one room to another. Okay. I also did a whole house inspection, and I took samples from the floors, and I took samples from the window trough or the window sill.
So the next question, which we all want to know, did we pass?
That is to be determined. All of the dust samples that were collected will be sent to the laboratory along with the chain of custody form. And once we get the results back from the laboratory, we will prepare a report from you that tells you whether or not all the dust samples passed or if any room need to be recleaned.
Oh, so what happens if we fail?
Yes, if you fail, we will let you know what areas of the home failed so that you can re-clean, have us back out to retest, send it back to the lab again. And once we get those results, we will let you know if you passed or failed.
And if we pass?
If you pass, then we'll finalize the documents that you can include with your disclosure form. indicating all the testing that we've done and that you ended up with passing results from every area of the home.
Well, thank you very much. And thank you all for watching this video of conducting a clearance examination. And now, just like you, we will have to wait until we get the results back from the laboratory.